What up, Sativa Nation? It's your boy, DB Douchebag here. Let's fucking do this shit. I am creaming right now. Fucking creaming. I'm fucking creaming because I have been a fan of this franchise for quite a while. I was a little bummed when apparently it was bought out by a bigger studio instead of being a indie project, but whatever. To be quite frank, after fucking 19 years of waiting for this shit, I would... I'll take whatever at this point. Besides, I don't think there's a whole lot of ways they can fuck this up. I mean, all you have to do is make action fighting mechanics and throw a couple of fucking quick time events in there. Kinda looks like they fucked up Ryo's eyes a little bit, but that's cool. Digest movie? You know what? Yeah, let's do a recap, because sometimes I feel like I'm the only fucking person who knows about this franchise. I talk to all my coworkers and they're like, I don't know what Shamu is. Oh, fuck yeah.
Yokosuka, 1986. Ryo Hazuki's fate is abruptly and irrevocably changed. When his father, Iwao, is murdered by a mysterious man named Lan Di, Ryo, young and inexperienced, is no match for him. Lan Di takes the dragon mirror, long hidden and guarded at the dojo. With his dying breath, Iwao imparts one last piece of wisdom to his son. Keep your loved ones close to you. Not yet able to fully appreciate the meaning behind those words, Ryo leaves the dojo behind and vows to take revenge against Lan Di. Ryo hunts for clues as to the whereabouts of his father's killer. A letter arriving all too late warns of encroaching danger. Its contents point Ryo towards a certain Master Chun, who reveals the existence of a second mirror. Unraveling the mysteries buried beneath the family dojo leads Ryo to this fabled Phoenix Mirror. However, this attracts a new threat. A crooked man named Chai stalks Ryo in hopes of getting his hands on the mirror. Thanks to the Chen family, Ryo manages to protect the mirror from Chai. He next decides to depart for Hong Kong in pursuit of Lan Di. More trouble, however, is already waiting for him before he leaves. From goons at the docks to a tough gang of bikers known as the Mad Angels. The evil that confronts him even moves to sink its teeth into his dear friend, Nozomi Arasaki. But Ryo's heart is driven, and with his comrades to aid him, he is able to overcome all obstacles in his path.
Oh, he did.
The waves lapping against his home shore tell Ryo he must now leave Japan to continue his quest. Having chosen a difficult path, Ryo Hazuki remains undeterred as his fate calls to him. He arrives in Hong Kong.
It's my fucking jam.
But in this unfamiliar land, who can he possibly trust? When his money is stolen and he is left destitute, he turns to the kindness of a young woman named Joy. He finds himself wandering the streets of Wan Chai to arrive at Mon Mo Temple. There he meets Xue Ying Hong, who claims to know something as to Lon B's whereabouts.
That fucking guy.
Sensing in Ro a thirst for bloody revenge, however, she refuses to talk. Instead, she attempts to dampen the flames of his rage through instruction, but her efforts prove in vain when Ro meets with a man named Ren Wu Ying. Learning of the Phoenix Mirror, Ren's mind turns toward the riches that could be theirs. Ren reveals that Zhu Renda has sequestered himself within the Kowloon Walled City.
I love Ren. He's an asshole, but I love him. Fool, I'm taking a leap.
But what waits for them in Kowloon is Dormio and the Yellowheads, a gang of brutal fighters in service to Lon D. Overpowers Dormio, but Lon B just manages to escape. Ryo learns that he has made for Guilin. Parting from the warm company he found in Hong Kong, Ryo continues the pursuit alone. A young lady named Shen Hua. This twist of fate will change everything for him and for her as well. What ancient mystery is locked away by the dragon and Phoenix mirrors? What of Lon D, whose hands are stained with the blood of Ryo's father?
Smoke him. Yeah, it only took you 20 fucking years, you pieces of shit. People have died waiting for this fucking... this goddamn title. I doubt the creator likes it any more than I do, so... cut you some slack. Oh, fuck my pussy. I do not know what I'm jumping into, and it has been a while since I've played either of the Shenmues. Alright. Take it easy at first. And if you're good to me, I'll do a second playthrough on fucking anal rapist mode. I was so expecting them to revamp, like, everything that didn't need to be revamped. Ugh. Yes. Yes! Daddy! Senpai! Ah, yes. Okay. Fuck you, assholes.
Hello, Leo.
Shenhua, who's this?
This is Leon. He saved me from drowning in the river.
Ah, fuck. I wanted to make you both my girlfriends. Yeah.
Did something happen?
A group of thugs tore through here 2 days ago.
Oh, no. Really?
Yeah. And kind of we don't normally see around here.
Let's keep moving. Hey, Shenhua.
What's the matter?
Does the village usually have gatekeepers?
No. There's no need for them. Bailu is a very peaceful place.
Are you sure about that? Because they said some thugs came by.
Yes, but it sounds like they're not from around here.
Still, that's worrying.
Even for you?
Yeah.
I admit, I'm a little unsettled myself. The village feels different somehow.
I can imagine.
Let's ask around for some clues.
Let's go. That was a pretty old bridge.
Indeed. That's the Verdant Bridge.
That's what it's called.
Yes. It's been in Bailu for a while.
Is that the village up ahead?
Yes. Everyone lives up ahead.
Good God, you're not fucking there yet?
Someone's bound to know something.
Let's not waste another second.
I concur. Wholeheartedly. Switch characters? If you run while your health is yellow, your health will deplete quickly. What the fuck? I don't remember that. I don't remember that shit. Oh, Ryo, you gotta get that workplace distraction up out of here, man. What the fuck?
Sure, we'll find out more about your father.
Thanks. You investigate here, Ryo. I'll try another settlement.
Alright, I would not want you around my kids, brother. Let me Chester the molester over here.
Come to apprentice under me, have you?
Oh, nothing.
Fear not, for I am the great Su Zixiong. I can
forge
a formidable master out of the most hopeless of pupils. You stand before a Chun Tai Chi master.
Yeah, I'm good, thanks. Have you seen Mr. Yuan?
Do I look like I'd know anything about that?
Right.
Come by any time if you got
Do I look like I know anything about anything? Who the fuck are you?
Excuse me.
Hey there, lad. How about a game?
Uh-oh. I don't want to grab your dick, sir.
Do you have a moment?
It costs 10 euron to play. You open your wallet, or I shut my mouth.
Well, fuck you. Cunt face. No. Taro?
Excuse me.
What is it?
Have you seen Mr. Yuan?
He occasionally came to visit Joe next door, but Joe is likely working right now. Maybe Joe's daughter Lin knows where he is.
I see. I need help with something.
What do you want?
Well, fuck you, bitch.
I'm looking for someone named Yuan.
No, I haven't. Not since I saw him go to that house over there. But that was a while ago.
Okay, thanks. Do you have a moment?
What is it?
Excuse me.
What is it? Don't get all cozy with me.
Okay.
Get out of my fucking way then. Oh, cool. I thought I was going out of bounds. Oh, come on, you piece of shit. You fucking... Why let me come back here if I can't... Ah, good. No jump button. Just like the good old days. Jesus titty fucking Christ. Okay. Do it your way. Aw.
Hey there.
Yeah?
That looks great.
Yep, Shenhua tells me that too.
You know Shenhua?
She's my friend. Is she your friend too?
Yeah, she is. Say, do you know Mr. Yuan?
No.
He's a stonemason.
I know when you're hiding something from me, you little cunt.
Daddy?
Your dad is a stonemason as well? Talk to him?
He comes home at 7 at night.
He does. Okay, thanks.
No problem.
What the fuck is that? Jump system? Oh. I thought it meant like a jump, like a literal jump. Oh no shit, you guys added the option to fucking jump. This ambiance. Some good ass music, too. It's the little things, okay?
Hi there.
Don't break my balls.
Are you from Japan by chance?
Yes.
Japan may be a small island country, but I've heard that it has steep mountains with great streams.
Yeah, you're not wrong.
Huh? You don't fish them?
Not really my thing.
I don't have time to waste with someone who doesn't even know.
Got a second?
What do you want?
I need help with something.
I have nothing to say to a stranger. I've gotta eat first.
Okay then.
How about you suck my dick? I'll give you something to eat, you piece of shit, you little twink.
Excuse me.
Oh, I'm getting sleepy. It's a shame I can't stay up like I used to.
I see.
God damn it, when can I fight?
Hey.
What is it, dear?
Oh, Jesus.
I've got a question. Have you seen Mr. Yuan?
I'm sorry, dear, but could you save that for later? This is no place for idle chit-chat.
Jesus Christ, will anybody talk to me?
Excuse me.
What is it?
Have you seen Mr. Yuan?
Not recently, no. He doesn't come to the village square all that often.
I see. Do you have a moment?
What is it?
There's something I want to ask.
Why does everybody always greet themselves like I'm holding a gun?
I'm looking for Mr. Yuan.
What is it?
Okay.
It's like I'm a serial rapist or some shit. What the fuck is that?